Blackstone Audio presents Long Texan, a Western duo by William MacLeod Raine. This book is read by Chris Abell. Scalisi Claws Leather. Mr. Scalisi looked over the breakfast menu card sourly. His swarthy face wore the dissatisfied expression of one not at peace with his world. He had not slept well. In Arizona, it seemed to be a quaint custom to go to bed at night. Where he came from, the great city woke to life only after a million lights flung out their blazing challenge to the darkness. When at last his day ended, the clang and roar of the streets were music lulling him to the placid slumber of an honest gangster. The stillness that pressed in on him here made him want to scream, as though he were being buried in a great coffin 1,000 miles away from anyone. After he snarled out his order, he leaned back and waited impatiently, his fingertips drumming on the table, his black beady eyes wandering around the dining room. The eyes came to rest on a waitress, the one who had charge of the rear corner tables on the south. His bold gaze traveled up and down her slender trimness and approved. There was a quality shy and sweet about her fresh youth, not usual in the women he knew. He watched her whenever she was in the room. On his way out, he stopped for a moment at the office to buy cigarettes.
"Have me change to a table near the back on the sunny side," he told the clerk. "Yes, Mr. Peters." "What's the name of the blonde waitress with the pink cheeks?"
"Her name is Rose Dunn."
The clerk spoke with awe in his voice. He knew that Peters was an alias. The man was the notorious Pete Scalisi, the gang leader who made millions yearly defying the law, who condemned his enemies to death with 5 words spoken out of the corner of his thin-lipped mouth. Mr. Scalisi walked to the corral. 3 young men in high-heeled boots and wide-brimmed hats were roping a wild colt that had to be broken to the saddle. 6 guests of the Dude Ranch, most of them young men and girls, also in cowboy boots and big hats, sat on the corral fence and watched the show. One of the girls caught sight of the newcomer and whispered to the youth beside her. This was observed by Mr. Scalisi with satisfaction. For reasons urgent, Pete Scalisi had come to Arizona incognito. Entirely in the way of business, it had been necessary for him to put 3 of the Northside gang on the spot. To show he had no hard feelings, he had attended the funeral with 4 armed guards after contributing costly floral tributes. His overtures had been neglected. The Villanos were Sicilians and had exhibited a narrow-minded bitterness. 2 of Scalisi's men took the one-way ride, and Pete himself was marked for death. This was disturbing. Pete liked to play at being a Superman, but it was unnerving to find his foes attempting the same role. Within a month or two, Pete intended to slip back to the big city where he would make the necessary arrangements for Joe and Mike Villano to be rubbed out by a machine gun volley from an armored car. Then everything would be okay. He would once more be the big boss and a stream of gold would again flow into him. But although Pete had come to hide from vengeance, it was characteristic of him that he had to betray his own secret. His vanity was greater than his fear. He bragged. In hints. He made a present to the hotel clerk of the book a newspaper man had written about him, Pete Scalisi, Napoleon of Gangsters. Within 40 hours of his arrival at the Bar BQ guest ranch, every corral dog on the place was aware of the identity of the new dude who called himself Peters. The ropers saddled and blindfolded the pony. One of them, a lithe, broad-shouldered young fellow, swung to the back of the animal. As soon as his feet had found the stirrups, the blind was slipped from the eyes of the bronco and the horse released. Instantly, the 3-year-old swept into cyclonic action. The battle was magnificent. The young range horse pitched wildly, went sunfishing, whirled in the air, and fought savagely to dislodge the human clothespin clamped to his back. One of the girls on the fence swung her cowboy hat and shouted encouragement,
"Ride him, Jim! Stick to him!"
The dudes joined in a chorus of applause. Scalisi said nothing. His eyes foliated the movements of an infuriated animal until it had been ridden to a standstill. Bully for you.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.